Salvation is available for all, no? Regardless of who they are. Now, I don't mean to say na everybody is already saved or will be saved eventually. Yung paniniwala na yon ay tinatawag na universalism. No, I don't believe in that. But I do believe that salvation is available for everyone, anyone. No, hindi namimili si Lord kung sino ang maaring makatanggap at makaranas ng tunay na kaligtasan. All that is needed, of course, is faith, no? True faith, no? Pero itong faith na to must have a certain quality to it and also a specific content. Hindi lang basta faith in general, no? It is not enough for people to simply say that they have faith. You know, in what exactly, in what way do they believe, no? Many people claim that they believe but are not saved. In addition po, what exactly do they believe in? Okay, so how do they believe and what do they believe in? Many people believe that God exists, for example, pero they remain disconnected or separated from God, no? Hindi pa nila nararanasan yung true salvation. So bakit ganun? We must understand, you know, how salvation is made available for everybody, okay? Not meaning to say na parang everyone will be saved eventually or everyone are already saved just because tao sila. We don't believe that. I don't believe that, of course. I don't believe yung tinatawag na anonymous Christian, yung parang yung idea na merong mga tao na ligtas na sila simply because they believe in the general concept of God. So, I think that's a wrong teaching. The Bible does not say that. But instead, the Bible says that salvation is available for everyone for as long as or if they are going to have real faith. At yung faith na yon is of a certain quality and a certain content. So, yan ang pag-uusapan natin today. You know, salvation is for everyone. And our passage is Romans chapter 4, verse 23 to 25. The last part, the concluding part nitong section kung saan Paul has taken a lot of time to establish, no? Yung sinfulness ng lahat ng tao, Jew and Gentile, regardless kung sino pa sila. And also yung availability, no, of the gospel, no, for everyone. Kaya this is the conclusion of that long section starting in Romans chapter 1, you know, from verse 18 onwards. Now, ito ang sabi niya sa Romans 4:23 to 25. So basahin po natin. The words it was credited to him were written not for him alone. That is referring to Abraham, no? But also for us to whom God will credit righteousness. For us who believe in him, who raised Jesus our Lord from the dead. And then finally in verse 25, he was delivered over to death for our sins and was raised to life for our justification. So it's a short passage po tayo today. And let's pray, manalangin po tayo. We would consider the context, of course, para maunawaan natin tong passage na to. But let's pray right now and ask God to guide us dito sa ating meditation. Father, we thank you and we praise you for today. And Lord, first and foremost, we pray for the elections. We pray for peaceful and orderly elections, Panginoon. Nawa, Lord, ay maging maayos lang po lahat ang proseso, and regardless of the results, Lord God, we would trust in your goodness and character na hindi mo kami pababayaan, Lord. I pray, Lord, we all pray na kahit na ano pa yung maging mga resulta, Lord, na maging peaceful pa rin yung sitwasyon sa Pilipinas, hindi yung maging magulo, Panginoon. We also pray for our devotions for today, more importantly. We pray, Lord, na you would speak to us and guide us and help us, O Lord, sa aming meditations so that by the grace of God ay maunawaan namin, Lord, ang sinasabi mo sa iyong salita. So, tulungan mo kami, dear Lord, and by your grace, we open our hearts to you to hear what your Spirit is saying. Thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name, amen and amen. So, purihin ang ating Panginoon. Let's talk about this topic, no? Yung availability ng salvation, no? For everyone. Salvation is for everyone. Hindi ibig sabihin na parang automatically, if you are a human being, eh, masisave ka na agad. But it is offered to everyone, no? And everyone can have access to it through faith. So, we ask the question today, how is salvation available for everyone? No? And basically, there are two ways. At yung two ways na yun, of course, is not either or, but both. You know, dalawang bagay na magkasama ito. First of all, you know, in terms of quality. Faith kasi ang susi, pero what kind of faith? No? So, people must believe like Abraham. That's what Paul is saying, no? Now, it is available for all, pero for all who would believe like Abraham believed. And so, tingnan natin to, no? So, verse 23-24, no? Is there a basis for that statement? Sabi ni Apostle Paul, the words it was credited to him, no? Which is yung sinabi niya earlier, and we'll look at that. Were written not for him alone, no, but also for us to whom God will credit righteousness. Okay, let's just stop there for a second. At review lang natin yung kanyang sinabi dun sa earlier passage, particularly dito sa verse 18. Sabi niya kasi sa verse 18, yung nauna, no, against all hope, Abraham in hope believed, and so became the father of many nations, just as it had been said to him, so shall your offspring be. Again, sabi niya rito, verse 19, without weakening in his faith, he faced the fact that his body was as good as dead, since he was about 100 years old, and that Sarah's womb was also dead. No, we talked about this, pero I'm just going to read it, no? So verse 20, yet he did not waver through unbelief regarding the promise of God, but was strengthened in his faith and gave glory to God, being fully persuaded that God had power to do what he had promised. So yung idea ng promise, no? Abraham trusted God's promise. This is why, sabi niya, it was credited to him as righteousness. And so, when we look at the verse 23, the words it was credited to him, we know the context. No? So, madaling salita, Paul is saying na salvation is available for all. Ito ay para sa lahat. But only in terms of yung having the same faith as Abraham did. Ano ba yung faith ni Abraham? You know, Abraham believed in the promise, no? Promise sa kanya. In the context, of course, ng kanyang situation, he believed God na God is going to fulfill yung promise niya sa kanya that he would be blessed and he would be a blessing to many nations and that he himself will have his own son and out of him will come many nations. So, technically, wala siyang pwedeng asahan sa sarili niya because he was already 100 years old. And then Sarah was of course barren, ano? In other words, parehong mabaga imposible on his own to make such a vision a reality, nung sinasabi ni Lord sa kanya, no? You can find this in Genesis 12 and then later on sa Genesis 15, you know, kung saan the Lord was making a promise to him that was so outstanding and so talagang magnificent na there is no way that it could ever happen sa sarili niya. And then, this is of course what Paul is talking about sa verse 23 and 24. The words it was credited to him were written not on him alone, but also for us to whom God will credit righteousness. So now he is applying the same thought na pinaliwanag niya concerning Abraham, and now applying it to everyone else, no, who would believe as Abraham believed, believing in the promise of God, na, you know, without wavering or, you know, sa sarili niya, because, and not trusting in oneself, but believing in God who has the power, you know, to give life to even, you know, in the face of death, like in the case of, kumbaga, Abraham being 100 years old and Sarah's womb, eh, ano, barren, you know. So, in retrospect, pag ni-review natin what Paul has been saying all throughout up to this point, okay, dito sa kanyang ine-emphasize na, you know, will credit righteousness, he has already declared na lahat ng tao ay under the power of sin and are guilty before God, whether Jew pa yan, Gentile pa yan. In other words, no one is able, no, to justify himself before the Lord. No one is capable also of, you know, obeying God's will as reflected in the law. Everyone has fallen short. And Paul took the time talaga to establish that. So pag sinabi natin na ang kaligtasan is available for all, and in terms of quality, what we mean to say is that it is available for all who would believe like Abraham. Ang ibig sabihin nito, like Abraham, I also must come to the realization na una sa lahat na I'm not able to save myself, I'm not able to fulfill God's will, you know, whether based sa the scriptures, yung ni-reveal niyang will niya, or even based sa conscience ko. Paul has already declared that, you know, and explained that clearly. But also, it means na after, you know, recognizing na talagang wala akong way to bring about my own salvation, which is parang similar to Abraham seeing himself, di ba? Na parang wala na siyang pag-asa being 100 years old, and yung wife niya is, ano, si Sarah is barren, ano? Kumbaga, on his side, there is no way na may magagawa pa siya, no? So in the same manner, a person who recognizes na sa sarili niya ay wala na siyang magagawa, and then looks to God who makes a promise, in the same way na si Abraham looked to God who made a promise to him. And so siya, sabi sa Bible, he was fully persuaded that God had the power to fulfill what he promised. So in the same way tayo, we hear God, you know, proclaim to us the gospel, no, that through faith in his son we will be saved. So we believe God, we put our faith in God. And so ito yung sinasabi ni Paul, na just like Abraham, we believe God's promise that is contained in the gospel. And we don't believe in ourselves in a sense na parang kaya natin iligtas ng sarili natin. We can never be righteous before God. There's nothing we can do to fulfill God's righteous demands through the law. Lahat tayo, we fall short. Hindi natin kayang, you know, maging banal sa harapan ng Diyos. Instead, we are all guilty before God. We are all objects of God's wrath. If God will not intervene and rescue us, we are doomed to be eternally separated from God, no, in hell. Pero thanks be to God that God made a promise. So, is salvation available for everyone? Yes, if they would believe like Abraham, meaning if they would, ano, agree with the Lord, no, and accept the fact na hindi nila kayang iligtas ng sarili nila, and that in fact they are slaves to sin, and that they are, of course, guilty before God, and if they are willing to trust God in His mercy and grace, no, as expressed in Jesus Christ our Savior. So yes, it is available for everyone. Everyone who would believe like Abraham. So this is the good news. So sinasabi ni Pablo na ang salvation ay para sa lahat, hindi lang para sa mga Hudyo, kundi para din sa mga Gentiles o yung mga tao na hindi pinanganak na Hudyo. It is for everyone, provided that they also would exercise faith. No? So salvation is for everyone who believes, kahit sino pa sila. Basta yung faith na yun, of course, is a faith that is like Abraham. Now, if we're going to apply it sa panahon natin ngayon, there are people who would say that they believe, you know, or they might even say na they believe in the gospel, pero deep down inside, they believe that they are still good people, na kaya nilang iligtas ang sarili nila. And we have talked about it in the previous devotions natin. There are people who actually siguro see themselves as being, sabihin na natin, parang naturally good people sila. Hindi sila masasamang tao, hindi sila mga rapists or murderers. No? Maybe they see themselves as being, you know, righteous. Well, if that is how you see yourself, di ba? Then, you know, you will not experience yung salvation that God wants you to experience. Kasi feeling mo, all you have to do lang is to be a good person, just obey the rules, ika nga. So your salvation is not going to be poured out in your life because you seem to have it all together, no, already. So merong mga tao who are self-righteous, even now in the churches natin, in the body of Christ, may mga Christians who look to themselves as if parang, you know, babait na sila. And so that's why when you look at their lives, there is very little transformation that is going on because they see themselves as parang deserving, no, to be accepted by God kasi mabait sila. Or maybe, to put it in another way, which is, I think, very common, there are people who actually, you know, probably hate themselves or feel parang ano sila, wala silang kwentang tao and they will never be accepted by God. So they turn away from God or they, you know, they withdraw kasi masama sila, feeling nila. Which is the same thing actually, it's still pride. It's still the idea na sa akin nakasalalay whether God will accept me or not. So to believe like Abraham is to accept that there's nothing really that I can do, no? To save myself. You know, whether in a, sabihin natin, in a positive light, na parang there's nothing I can do for me to be righteous before the Lord and to actually deserve God's acceptance. Wala. But also, it's true in the negative sense. Na kahit na ako ay, let's say, nagkakasala at nagkakamali, I also do not parang make it an issue that for some reason parang hindi ako lalapit kay Lord kasi masama akong tao. Kasi pride din yun, either way. It's still pride, you know? So, everyone, no, has the potential to experience yung salvation provided that they would believe just like Abraham. Completely accepting, you know, yung kanilang condition, parang yung sinasabi ni Abraham, di ba? He knew that he was basically incapable of doing anything, no? Para magkaroon siya ng ano, ng kumbaga, ng anak, no? It was impossible. He was 100 years old. Sarah was barren. So, zero sila as far as their situation is concerned. All they can really do is trust God's promise. So, in the same way, tayo rin po. If you want to be saved, if you want to experience salvation sa buhay mo, you have to renounce any kind of self-righteous delusion, no? Either in terms of yung ability mo to be righteous, o kaya yung belief mo that you are so parang unrighteous that God will have nothing to do with you. Either way, the same thing. If you reject, of course, the offer of God and the promise of God, either because of your pride, na, you know, or your self-righteousness, o kaya yung parang nire-reject mo yung offer ni God kasi feeling mo napakasama mo. Either way, it's the same thing. you will not experience the saving grace of God. But if you would believe as Abraham believed, trusting God in His promise, then you will be saved. Now, the second aspect nitong question natin, you know, how is salvation available for everyone? Let's not forget na it also has to do with the content of our faith. Hindi sapat that we just believe, period. There is something that we must believe in. And so people must believe in the gospel. In other words, it's available for everyone, pero hindi yung parang katulad ng paniniwala ng ilang mga tao, and maybe, I don't know if some of you listening right now believe that, na, well, pag ang isang tao, kung hindi naman siya nakakapakinig pa ng gospel, pero he's trying to be a good person, in effect, he also believes, kaya lang, you know, maybe he doesn't believe yet in Jesus, kasi hindi naman niya alam, so he's just trying to be a good person based sa conscience niya. So some people would say na, well, yung tao na yun, saved din yun. Well, there's nothing in the Bible that agrees to that thought, no? Instead, what we see in the Bible is that it has to have a specific content. People must believe in the gospel. Hindi lang yung parang believe generally. For example, may mga tao na naniniwala na may Diyos. That by itself cannot be, you know, the means for our salvation kasi it's such a vague content, you know. Sino ba yung God na tinutukoy natin? That's why in the Bible, no, laging merong, ano yung, parang qualification, the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. So, meron siyang qualification. So, let's look at verse 20. Well, actually, starting in the second part of verse 24 and then until 25. Ganito ang sabi sa last part ng verse 24. For us who believe in Him who raised Jesus our Lord from the dead. So here is a crucial statement, no, na sinasabi. It's not just simply believing in Jesus in general, but believing that Jesus was raised from the dead. No, in other words, the resurrected Jesus. Kaya very important yung resurrection. No? Unfortunately, for a lot of people today, yung Easter Sunday has become more of a parang a celebration for the Easter Bunny, no? O kaya yung nawawalang itlog, no? Nawala na yung significance ng resurrection itself. Some people still, of course, celebrate yung Holy Week, lalo na yung ano, Good Friday. Pero pagdating ng Sunday, parang naiiba na yung focus. But for the early church, what they declared, no, sa kanilang confession at sa kanilang proclamation is that Jesus rose again from the dead. He is the risen Lord, no? Kaya nga, Jesus our Lord, okay? Again, in verse 25, sabi niya, He was delivered over to death for our sins. Now, this is of course something na, you know, kailangan natin panampalatayaan, na Jesus died on our behalf. He did not die na para bang napagkaisahan lang siya, pinagtulungan lang siya. Minsan kasi sa Good Friday, ang focus ng mga tao is more on the suffering rather than on the true meaning of His death. There were many people who were crucified at that time. Pero, you know, there's no merit dun sa pagka-crucify sa kanila. The only reason why the crucifixion of Christ has merit for us is because it is Christ who is crucified. No? So that's why pag binasa mo yung Gospels, very little yung pag narrate o pag-explain kung gaano kahirap yung pinagdaanan ni Jesus. Ano nga, very parang limited nga yung narration o language. Hindi talaga masyado dinidetalye paano pinako, ganito. Parang sinabi lang na he was, you know, crucified, no? Very short and very succinct, no? Parang gano'n. Because the focus is not on the difficulty of what Jesus went through. Kasi ganyan yung madalas na maririnig natin sa mga tao na parang ang mahalaga talaga is maawa tayo kasi nag-suffer si Jesus ng sobra. But that's not really the point. The point is that He was delivered over to death. Now, this is important. God offered Jesus Christ, no? as the sacrifice for our sins. He was delivered over to death for our sins. Yun ang significance ng crucifixion ni Christ or the death of Christ. Yung substitution. Imbis na tayo yung ma-crucify doon, instead of us paying the price for our sins, Jesus took it upon himself. No? He is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Very important ito sa content ng faith natin. That we actually put our faith in the sufficiency of what Jesus has done on our behalf. That He died for our sins. So, hindi sapat na parang sabihin lang natin na we believe. What exactly do we believe in? Diba? What is the content of our faith? And so the Apostle Paul is saying, dapat ang content ng faith mo is that Jesus actually died for your sins. He paid for it. So that's very important. Now, secondly, sabi rito, and this is surprising, and a lot of people miss this actually when they read the scriptures. Sabi, and was raised to life for our justification. Now, normally, yung mga tao, they would think of their justification dun sa crucifixion. Pero dito, Paul is saying that we are justified when Jesus was raised to life. Which presupposes na yung justification natin is not just parang a one-time, judicial event na parang dineclare na ni Lord na we are righteous. Of course, that is true. Binago niya na yung status natin. But some people conclude na hanggang dun lang, you know, okay, we are justified, we stand before God as righteous, which is of course true, pero they stop there and they do not consider kung ano pa yung implications noon. Because here Paul is saying, was raised to life. In other words, yung ating justification doesn't stop with our change of status. It actually involves in our transformation also, kung saan the righteousness of God, hindi lang basta natin status, it becomes a reality sa buhay natin through the work of the Holy Spirit. And it is the risen Lord who is at work ngayon sa mga taong nananampalataya sa Kanya. And we are justified, not just in a sense na parang one time, nagbago yung status natin, but we can also say na yung justification na yun continues on sa buhay natin through the power of the resurrection that is at work sa buhay natin. Now, this is very important because yung content ng ating faith cannot just be parang in general about God. We must believe in the gospel. So the gospel po is really the content of faith that will save us. Eh? Kasi if we say na I believe, pero basically I just believe that, you know, anyway, Jesus is a good person, that will not save us. Or I believe that there is God. I believe that Jesus died for my sins. No? So I have been reconciled with God. I am no longer an enemy of God. I also believe in the good news that through Jesus, my status is changed completely by grace through faith. I have not done anything to deserve it. Pero through Jesus, you know, I am seated with Him in the heavenly realm. So I have now a new status before the Lord. I am now a beloved of God. But I also believe in the gospel that says that every day my life is being transformed through the power of the Holy Spirit. And so therefore I need to cooperate with God. That's why the Bible says, work out your salvation with fear and trembling. I also believe that this is a journey. The gospel is also telling me that in the end, He will establish a new heaven and a new earth. And kung saan righteousness, you know, would cover everything, you know, as the waters cover the sea. So madaling salita, you know, this is the gospel. I cannot just simply believe, tapos question mark. I must believe in a certain reality called the good news, no? So, pag sinabi natin, how is salvation available for everyone? In terms of quality, people must believe like Abraham. Pero in terms of content, people must believe in the gospel. So in other words, salvation is for everyone who truly believes, just like Abraham, no, in the gospel. I know I've been saying it over and over again, pero it bears repeating, no? Kailangan natin ulit-ulitin. Salvation is for everyone who truly believes in the gospel. So, in terms of quality, I must truly believe, just like Abraham. I must renounce any kind of self-righteousness sa sarili ko, and I must believe in the promises of God. I must believe in God's faithfulness. Secondly, in terms of content, it is the gospel that I must believe in. So, if this is true in my case, if I truly believe, no, in the gospel, then salvation is mine. God offers His saving grace sa akin, no, which is a free gift, not something that I earn, but something that God bestows upon me by His grace through His Son, Jesus, my Savior and Lord. Dalangin ko po na lahat tayo ay magkaroon ng ganitong pagkaunawa. No? Available sa lahat, hindi nangangahulugan na lahat ay maliligtas, pero it's available for anybody who would truly believe in the gospel. Tayong lahat po ay manalangin at nawa ito ay makatulong sa atin, lalo-lalo sa personal nating buhay, at ganun din sa pag-share natin sa iba. Let us pray. Father, maraming salamat po for your grace and mercy, O God. And Lord, thank you. Thank you sa good news mo, Lord, na we all can be saved by believing just like Abraham believed in the gospel of God. Kung saan the gospel reveals the righteousness of God through faith in Jesus. Thanks be to God. Salamat po, Panginoon. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.